Huffington Magazine recently gave its readers some advice on what you should do if you get a bad haircut. Now, they say some suggestions are wear hair accessories or a new curling iron or try to wear it in a different style. My suggestion is don't go back to that damn salon if they cut your hair bad.
Yeah.
You know, but okay, ladies, what do you do? I'm throwing out the question. You get a bad haircut, what do you do?
Man, I hate that moment, too. I mean, you don't want to be too vain because you know your hair will grow, but looking whack for, like, with bangs that are up to here or you feel bald on one side, you feel so insecure, man. You pull out all your hats and your beanies. You try that old, like, trucker hat. I just, I think that I don't want to start crying about it, but I actually start pulling at my hair to make it grow faster. Have you ever done that where you're like, come on! I get, like, really, I hate bad haircuts.
Well, I haven't had a problem with bad haircuts. Well, I do have problems sometimes with bad, they cut my wig wrong. You know what I mean? You ever get that?
And then the wig is expensive because
it doesn't grow back. And then one time, I remember season two,
uh-huh.
I had this one hairstylist. He would always cut like Edward Scissorhand. He would just keep cutting my wigs. And so you can see, like, I started out like this, then I like this, then I was like... I was like, dude, stop cutting my wigs.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I remember, and I don't mean to take it deep, but when I was 18 years old, I started not using my real hair. And the reason was because I was in this trailer, and this hairstylist was doing my hair for a show that I was doing at the time. And I walked down the stairs, but I was still standing by the doorway. And the woman says, I hate doing black people's hair because it feels like pubic hair.
What?
And from that moment on,
dead.
And I asked the producers if I could say that word.
Right.
Yeah. But from that moment on, I wear wigs when I'm working because you don't know who's in your hair. And you don't know if, you know, their temperament.
Their energy and stuff like that.
Their energy. And my hair had fallen out by the time I overheard her saying that.
Wow.
So, yeah, I wear wigs.
You say calm, man. I would have walked, busted down that door.
So
when I show you what that woman's hair looks like.
At 18, I was a child. I was a young 18.
Right.
So
I just went to the producers and I was crying. And I was like, can you please just get me a wig so this woman never has to touch my hair again?
Wow.
Yeah.
Do you guys remember, well, actually, I think it was our trial. And you know how I was wearing my hair straight?
Yeah.
And, I mean, this guy, like, pressed it with a hot iron that my hair actually didn't curl back and my hair started falling out. That's the reason why I did the big chop.
Oh.
So for me, I had to chop like all of my hair off. I had to start all over. But when I look back, I don't regret that. It was an awakening moment for me because I didn't hide behind my hair anymore. You were forced, you know, to put everything all out here.
Yeah.
And, you know, I'm grateful for that experience now. But I don't know. With natural curly hair, I'm always doing something to it.
Yeah.
Either, you know, dyeing it all the time, putting the faux locks in when they took it out, like half of my hair was stripped. So I'm always usually having to cut it, or girl, I can rock a fedora. You'll see me do that a lot.
Okay.
Yes.
But now I'm learning to appreciate my hair in its natural state. And as you guys know, I haven't worn a wig since.
Yeah.
I've been wearing my
great.
Curly hair.
Really, really good.
Thank you, Lonnie.
I also hate when I go to the hairdresser and they think they doing good with your hair. You ever get that
where you can't speak back because they're like, trust me, I got it.
Yeah.
They
and then
like
they don't have
the
it.
The ones that's being too much?
Yeah,
oh my God.
It's like, always speak up, you know, because if you don't like something, speak up. And I'm glad when you were 18, you spoke up, you told the producers. That doesn't make sense, you know.